Hello and welcome to my creating room. My name is Brooke Shaden. I'm a fine art photographer and we're jumping into two edits today. Yes, two, because I thought it would be really fun if we took a look at how to manipulate walls, which is a weird thing to talk about, but we're gonna do it because it's really fun and I've got two really good examples here. So we've got this one image where I'm lifting the wall up to look outside. We've got a crack in the wall. Then there's this other one where my head is stuck under the wall. I do lots of weird things with walls, I have to say. I always have. I think they're just fascinating blank spaces that can hold so many secrets. So we're going to jump into these edits. So we'll start with this one. Let's just go to the top. We can see we've got a number of layers, but they're mostly just adjustments. So the actual compositing wasn't too strenuous for this image. So let's dive in. We've got the initial image here, which was just a room, just like a little wall corner of a wall space. And I wanted that to be the wall that I used as my, the one that I was looking under. So I used that as my background. Got the wall extended here just by mirroring it and making sure that it extends. And there I am coming in. That's my shadow underneath. You can see that helping to bring me into the space. Otherwise I'm just floating. So there we've got that. I shot this in my bedroom, just on my floor, lifting up a piece of fabric. And so that's how I did this manipulation of the wall. You can really see that here. So let's zoom in on the hand. And you can see that the hand is actually lifting fabric. I was in my room, I had a chair set up, and then I had a white bed sheet draped over the chair, and I would just lift it up to take the picture and look underneath it so that I was really doing the action. That helps so much in cases like this. I would rather go into this not necessarily like just mimicking the motion of lifting the fabric and looking. I would rather actually do it, because if I do, then it creates that realism where it touches the hand, it makes my pose more realistic. I think it's just all around a better choice. And then I added the sky out there. So I took photos of the night sky. I added that in. We've got one more crack. This was actually a texture that I took a picture of, just a, like one big crack in a wall that I duplicated to make both sides of the wall. So let me see if that makes sense. This was just a crack in a wall, just one single crack. I duplicated that over here, rotated it to make it look like there was a big crack in the wall. It's really just the same one. You can see, same one. I just changed it slightly so that maybe it wasn't super obvious, hopefully. I don't know. And then I added in the night sky out there as well. And this just gives this look like there really is something behind. Now I had to get rid of several things, like how bright I was and just making it more atmospheric. And so that's what all of these adjustments are going to do here. But manipulating walls in this case was a matter of using a bed sheet that I was able to blend into the wall because it was the same color, and a crack in the wall that I just used in a slightly creative way that maybe you wouldn't think to do. So if we go to the other one, then we can scroll all the way down to the bottom and see how this one was done. So there I am in position, head stuck out, right? And this is a stage that you can't make much sense of, but I extended the frame. Sometimes editing is weird, right? And then trying to fix it, trying to make it look good. All right, now in a totally separate picture, aside from, I wanted to make sure I had the pose, right? Like the main shot, all good, got my litter box in there. And so I wanted to make sure that I had the main pose, but I also took pictures of that fabric on my head where I was just pulling it. Like I had it on my head. No, I was just pulling it forward so that I did have fabric really making the shape of my head, digging into my neck there. And then I took pictures of it on the wall. So I kept stretching it out on the wall and just tried to use as many images as I can of that fabric stretched against the wall. This would work way better if you had a friend to help you. I didn't. Would have worked better. So there I got rid of the litter box that was plaguing us, right? Okay, and then this is where the composition got pretty final. So we've got all the fabric added in that I had stripped over my head and on the wall, each one a different piece. So this is a different piece, this is a different piece, this is a different piece, this one's different, the main part is different. And then I really start to blend it, make it look like it's really there, color the overall image. But you know, this wouldn't work if that sheet wasn't roughly the same color as the wall. That's the important thing here. Got a texture. And then this is a really cool one. Here we have a repeated pattern. And so what I did was I got one just like little, I don't know what you call it, shape, like vector drawing of just one little shape that I repeated over and over and over to make a wallpaper. And so I did that in a separate area, separate canvas in Photoshop, made my little repeating pattern, put it all together, dragged it on top of this image, and then used overlay to make it go into the image. I use this at 24%, this layer. So if we take it up, you can really see what's happened here with my repeating texture. But I took it down to 24%. And then just a few steps to finish. And that, I think, gave this extra realism because the pattern's on the wall and on this fabric. Another thing that I think added extra realism here was making sure to leave the neck a little bit white where the fabric would have dug into it. And I left some of the pattern on me as well because I wanted it to look like I was sort of becoming a part of the wall. So those are two different ways that I've manipulated walls, two different images to look at. I hope that you found that interesting and not totally completely weird, but I think it's really fun. And most of all though, even if you never do anything with this technique, it's still just a great way of getting out of your comfort zone and thinking in a totally different way than you might have before. So I hope you enjoyed it. I know I did. Have a wonderful week.